I will hearken unto what the Lord God will say, for he shall speak peace unto his people. Very warm welcome to New College Chapel for this special service to celebrate a century of music commissioned and premiered by the choir. We particularly welcome old members who were here for the garden party and former clerks and choristers from the Choir Association, as well as anyone joining us on the live stream. The introit was O Pastor Animarum, a new piece by Caitlin Harrison. The responses were by Matthew Martin, who was once assistant organist of this chapel. The Magnificat is from the New College service by Paul Drayton, former music director of New College School, and the Nunc, dimittis is from the service commissioned for the 40th anniversary of the admission of women to New College by the composer Deborah Pritchard. Wherever you are, we pray that you may find a glimpse of God's glory in this place. The service continues as the choir sings Psalm 85, which sings of God's mercy and forgiveness.
Thank you. first reading is written in the 40th chapter of the book of the prophet Isaiah, beginning at the first verse. Comfortee, comfortee, my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her, that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. For she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it. The voice said, Cry. And he said, What shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as the flower of the field. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, because the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people is grass. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. O Zion, that bringest good tidings, get thee up into the high mountain. O Jerusalem, that bringest good tidings, lift up thy voice with strength. Lift it up, be not afraid. Say unto the cities of Judah, Behold your God. Behold, the Lord God will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm, and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young. Here ends the first reading.
My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my soul hear it. The second reading is written in the third chapter of the letter of Paul to the Galatians, beginning at the 23rd verse. Now, before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore, the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. For in Christ Jesus, you are all children of God through faith. As many of you as were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ. There is no longer Jew or Greek, there is no longer slave or free, there is no longer male and female, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus. And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's offspring, heirs according to the promise. Here ends the second reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. It's a pleasure to have so many of you here tonight to celebrate all that the choir has achieved, and in particular to welcome the composers Caitlin Harrison, Toby Young, Deborah Pritchard, Paul Drayton, and Sir James Macmillan. You may have seen the display of CDs in the Antechapel. They will indeed be available after the service. This is the final Evensong of term, but tickets are also still available for the three choirs concert Sing Joyfully for the Oxford Festival of the Arts on 6 July at Christchurch. That's the choirs of New College, Magdalen College, and Christchurch. See the Oxford Festival of the Arts website for details. Also with Oxford Festival of the Arts, we are delighted to be hosting Nightlight, the display of paintings of Oxford at night by the artist James Gemmell. The display will be open to the public tomorrow from 10:30 to 5, with free entry to the college. The anthem this evening is the first performance of When One Man Dies by Sir James Macmillan, a setting of words from John Donne's Devotions Upon Emergent Occasions.
Thank you.
Let us pray. John Donne writes, "If I were but mere dust and ashes, I might speak unto the Lord, for the Lord's hand made me of this dust, and the Lord's hand shall recollect those ashes. I am the dust and the ashes of the temple of the Holy Ghost. And what marble is so precious? But I am more than dust and ashes. I am my best part. I am my soul. O shepherd of our souls, in the peace of the evening, we come to you as dust and ashes and seek in you our souls and the stardust of which they are made. We give back into your hands with sorrow and regret the sufferings of our world and our own part in them, whether large or small. At this time of change in our school and college, we pray for those who seek the new, for finalists and leavers, for all who go into the world encouraged, and for those who fear what lies ahead. We pray too for artists and musicians who enliven our dust and ashes and illuminate our souls. And we think on those we love and pray for release for any whose souls are smothered in pain or fear, who dread the toll of the bell. And finally, we remember in you those for whom the bell has tolled, the dying and the bereaved. In particular, William Petter, Alistair Putt, David Lumsden, and James Bowman. Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening, into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise nor silence, but one equal music, no fears nor hopes, but one equal possession, no foes nor friends, but one equal communion and identity, no ends nor beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitations of thy glory and dominion, world without end. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Amen. We stand to sing our closing hymn.
Thank you.
So you are wintered and frozen, clouded and eclipsed, damp and benumbed, smothered and stupefied. May God, who called light from deepest darkness, come to you not as the dawning of the day, but as the blazing sun at noontide. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.